Hi, I'm Anvana Ghosh. I'm a product manager in the Android team. And I would love to show you a demo of the Nexus 6P. This is our premium product that has been designed together with Huawei. And this is our first ever Android product with all aluminum body and made out of aeronautical grade aluminum. And this has a beautiful 5.7-inch screen and has Qualcomm quad-core processor, and it's very, very fast. And the battery is really good, so it will last you, along with all the Android M advancements that we made for a battery, for an entire whole day. It comes with a Nexus imprint, which is the fingerprint sensor, so you can use your fingerprint to unlock the phone very fast, as well as pay for your purchases through Android Pay. It has a great camera, something we are really excited about. It has a 12.3 megapixel camera at the back, which has the Sony imaging sensor, and it has 8 megapixel front-facing camera, which HDR plus, so you can take great selfies. And we know that people want to take photos really quickly in the moment, so we have made it easier to bring up the camera app with a double tap, so you can double tap the power button to bring up the camera. Oops. So there you go. You can take a picture with double tap on the power button. And of course, it's easy to relive the most moments with the Google Photos app because there is unlimited storage. The other thing that we are excited about is the Android Sensor Hub that we announced in Google in the keynote today. So the Android Sensor Hub is really a low power co-processor that connects to the sensors on these devices. So you can, as a user, stay connected to the device, and at the same time, your phone is not draining battery. A quick demo of that, when I pick up the phone, it wakes it up, and that is not done by the main processor, and the Android Sensor Hub is doing this, and it's really cool. So one of the things that we have done really on this device are these hardware features, but we are also excited to let you know that it also comes with the Android M, which is Marshmallow, our newest and the most delicious Android release. And there are two things that I would like to highlight. One is the Now on Tap. So let me unlock the phone. Oh, it's not set up. Let me unlock the phone. And let's say I'm reading up on Donald Trump. So I go to Twitter, and go to the Chrome app, and let's say I want to know more about Trump. Before M, then I would have to go out, do a search, or go to Twitter to find out all the relevant info. What Now on Tap does is it is an assistance that it's like an on-demand assistance. It lets me go deeper into the content without having to leave the app. So what I do is to just summon Google's assistant by long pressing on the home button. And look how all these apps that are already available on my devices are here for me for a quick tap. So I can tap on Twitter to see his tweets and read up on his tweets. So this doesn't just work on Chrome. I can show you another demo where I can go to Hangouts.
Ready for that?
And well, let's see if I have it. Hangouts message from my friend inviting me to Bar Agricole and check out the movie Everest. And I don't know much about the Bar Agricole, so I can summon Google's assistant by pressing on this home button, and I can read up on Yelp about the bar. Oops, sorry about that. Let's try again. And then I can read up on Flixster about the movie Everest. So it really makes me easy, helps me out by making it easier to stay within the app and not having to leave it. The other example, the other thing about Marshmallow is our runtime permissions. So with N, we have really focused on security to make it easier for the user to have control and choice over their data. A quick example is, let's say the Keep app. Let's find the Keep app. Yep. So Keep is a note-taking app, and I can take a note using voice commands. So now Keep is asking me whether it can use the microphone. And if I'm cool with that, I will just tap allow, and I can record my voice note. But let's say if I'm not cool anymore, I can go to the settings and go find the Keep app in under apps and go to... Go to permissions, and I can take out Keep's permission for microphone. So this provides me as a user with a choice and control of our apps, and then I can keep control using Keep without the microphone access.